Now, it wouldn't be Christmas Day without some presents. And Scott Tweedy is wearing a deliciously ugly Christmas jumper.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas.
Now, I've got some presents for you all. There you go,
Denise. Thank you.
So, hang on a second. So, we all did a Christmas Kringle. We don't know who bought for us. So, we need to unwrap and reveal who we think bought for us.
Okay. This could get awkward. Okay.
Are you going to hang around?
I'm going to come back a little while later. So, enjoy your presents. I've got nothing to do with these presents at all.
We thought delivering them. You were our present.
You can't unwrap it.
Secret Santa Scotty.
All right.
Here we go. Denise, you go first. All right. If I could open it, it's wrapped very well.
Oh, here we go.
All right, okay. It's rattled.
It's not smelling salty.
It's sleep. It's sleep stuff. So that would have to be. Have I got a guess now?
Yes. Who you think gave that to you?
It'd be someone who knows that I'm not awake for most of the show because I haven't slept the night before. That could be any one of you. I'm thinking Joe. That's a very thoughtful gift. Excuse me.
I know from our many conversations that you do have difficulty sleeping, and I'm not always going to be there to tell you stories about Roman history. Yeah.
Your turn, Hildebrand.
Okay. The dog has to love me now.
Oh,
that is beautiful. Look, I would have to guess it's someone who's obviously listened to me complain ad nauseum about my dog, and probably I suspect another dog lover. Is it you, Kat? Thank you.
Miss Kat, your turn to open.
Okay, here we go. Oh, how unusual for me. And it's something I can wear right now. It's not too much. I gotta love that. Oh, I've gotta say, it's between the. It's gotta be Sarah.
It was me. And I must say, I got the brief wrong. I thought it was Sequin Santa, not Secret Santa. So, apologies. My turn.
Okay.
Ooh, what could it be?
I know who this can come in at.
Angela Bishop, for your love of period drama. I know you're passionate about it.
Do you know what? I do like me some Colin Firth. So he's what's going to get me over the line. Thank you, darling.
That's all right. I want you to enjoy the 6 hours of your life you're going to
devote. 6 hours?
Jane Austen's finest.
There's even a 5-minute program explaining the restoration process. Thank you.
Your holidays are sorted.
No, thank you. Thank you.
It's actually quite sorts of your love it. The original working title was Who's on Firth?
Look out for the scene where he dives into the
dam. That's the only part of the movie I know. It was a book, right, at one point?
Jane Austen. Yeah. She's quite famous. Okay, what have I got? I've got Lux drink holders, party disco birds. What are these? They go in the pool and hold your drink.
You blow them up and you get a puncture kit with
them.
Yes,
these are great.
You seem to know a lot about them, Denise. Could this be from you?
Denise,
no.
She doesn't even have a pool.
No, but
she lives on the 11th floor of a building.
Yeah, but who would actually blow up flamingos and use them in a pool anyway? They're fun, Sarah.
I would not in Hollywood.
It's the bath.
It's a bath. For the bath.
The water bed.
For the water bed.
You know what it is, and I know it is true. It's Denise, because Scotty from Melbourne, so she just thinks that everyone in Sydney has a pool.
Come on. Loosen up, people. You never know when you might get a
pool.
That's
right.